May 3, 1882, Manila, Philippines. A 20-year-old Jose Rizal boards the SS Salvadora and sails for Singapore. With tears in his eyes and gloom in his heart, he gazed at the receding skyline of Manila. Then, he took out his pencil and his paper and sketched the land as it vanished into view. Rizal's travels in Europe is the subject of many studies today, because we believe that this chapter of his life served a major role in transforming the Philippine national hero into how we know him today. His main mission was to continue his medical degree in Spain, and only a handful of people knew about his plan at that time. In fact, to avoid being detected by the Spanish friars, he even booked his tickets under the name Jose Mercado, and only informed his parents and Leonor Rivera when he had already left, because he knew that they would not approve of it. Other than medicine, Rizal had another mission in Europe, which was to study their culture, language, customs, and even their government. We believe that his travels were the greatest influence and inspiration for his famous novels, Noli Me Tangere and El Filibusterismo. During his stay, he was amazed at how liberated the European people were. They had access to all kinds of scientific knowledge and can even freely say their political and philosophical opinions without the fear of being punished. Rizal may have even been jealous of this. He wanted his fellow countrymen to experience such freedom as well. Thus, he began preparing himself for the greatest task of liberating the Philippines from its Spanish oppressors. To further elaborate his travels and how this affected his novels, I will let TJ take over from here. So buckle up, we're heading to Singapore!
Thank you, Kyle, for that learning you have. Hi guys, I'm TJ, and now let's travel backwards on the year 1882. In 1882, as Rizal had his visit tours in different places with the boat he's riding named the Gemna, he also had a two-day trip to Singapore. Rizal was in awe when he landed on this place and was impressed with the place's greenery and scenery made his bare eyes full, but was later on accused of being a fugitive in Singapore and proceeded to Europe in Madrid to complete his medical studies and to make a name as a journalist and to observe European society as he arrived in September 1882. He then took medical courses and painting classes in Universidad Central de Madrid and Real Academia de Bellas Artes de San Pedro in Calle Alcalá. A very thirsty for knowledge kind of person, now joined a group named Circulo Hispano-Filipino in 1882, an association created and formed by Filipino students in Spain, composed of Filipinos and Spaniards. The reason he joined the association is to improve and make a change for the Philippines during the Spaniards' colonization, and then continued writing and created this masterpiece, Noli Me Tangere and El Filibusterismo. It's not just Singapore and Madrid, guys! Now let's have Diane for a delightful trip to Paris!
Thank you for that wonderful story, TJ. Hey guys, I'm Diane, and now let us explore Rizal's thrilling trip in 1883. As Rizal went to Paris, he visited different tourist spots. He was also mistaken to be a Japanese. Because of this, food, accommodation, and tickets were priced higher than the other nationalities. He then realized that he cannot afford to live in Paris, so he went back to Madrid. While in Madrid, Rizal joined a masonry and got the diploma as the Master Mason. When the Filipinos gathered for Juan Luna and Felix Hidalgo's achievement in a prestigious painting competition in Madrid, Rizal gave in a broad speech which was the Brindis speech, a toast honoring Juan Luna and Felix Hidalgo. Rizal completed his medical studies in Madrid and attained the title of Licentiate of Medicine. However, due to financial difficulties, he was not able to present his thesis and he did not get the title Doctor of Medicine. These events had affected the novels of Rizal because it gave him a deeper expression for his sense of nation. His knowledge of different cultures from his travels also became his way on how to inspire the Filipinos. This allowed him to prepare himself for the great task of liberating the oppressed Filipinos from the tyranny of the Spanish. And now, let's have Carl to show us a rewind on the year of 1885.
Thank you, Diane, for that learning you shared. Hey guys, I'm Carl. Let's continue to the year of 1885. After completing his studies, he headed to Paris in Germany in order to obtain his specialization in ophthalmology and acquire more knowledge about it. While he was in the different European countries, he was observing their customs and lifestyle. In November of 1885, Rizal lived in Paris for 4 months, working as an apprentice for Dr. Louis de Wecker, a renowned French ophthalmologist, and his knowledge on ophthalmology has greatly improved. While not working, he visits his friends and spends his time in the studio of Luna, where he also improved his painting skills. He then traveled across the different cities of Germany. In November 1886, he arrived in Berlin, where he observed that there was no racism. His intelligence was recognized and was acknowledged as the first Asian to be given honors for being a member of the Anthropological Society. He spent his time wisely, works in the day, and learns lectures and languages at night. Rizal finished his novel, The Nolimi Tangere, in Berlin, though it hasn't been published yet. Rizal was loaned enough funds by Maximo Viola in order to publish it. With the novel's publishing, they celebrate Christmas happily. On March 21, 1887, the novel Nolimi Tangere came off the printing press, and Rizal immediately sent copies to his close friends. The novel was dedicated to the Philippines and was appreciated greatly by his friends, especially Ferdinand Blumentritt, a German professor, which stated that this novel was based from the heart and that the heart also speaks.
From Singapore to Madrid, Germany, and Paris, these travels shaped Jose Rizal into the hero that we see him today. And we can see in his novels his dedication and desire to free the country. We hope that this video helped you in showing just how great this person is. That's all. Thanks for watching.